In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can create base and projected views in an Autodesk Inventor drawing. To create a base view, we simply select the Base tool on the Place Views tab. The dialog box will display any open files. If you want to create a drawing of another file, you can simply browse for it. You can see a preview of the view, and I can click and drag before I place this view. I can also adjust which view I'm looking at by using the view cube. So I can select a different view as needed. I can even rotate it around to get the view that I want. I can adjust the scale. I can go smaller or larger. I can also determine if I want to show hidden lines or not, and if I want it shaded or not. So I'll go ahead and show hidden lines on this particular one, then click OK. So here you can see my default view here. I want to go ahead and project off of this view, so I'll simply select the projected view button, select the view, then I can move away from the view to create additional views. So I can create a top, left, right, bottom. I can even create the isometrics as well. So I'll create an isometric in each direction. Then when I'm done, I'll right click and select create. Very easily, we can generate multiple views of a part. By default, these views are going to be locked together. So they're all locked to that parent view. I can't just simply drag and drop them wherever I want on this sheet of paper. If I double click on a view, I can edit it. So I can edit the original view and, for example, turn off the hidden lines and click OK. You'll notice that all other views updated. If I double click on one of these views, you can see that it is set to get its scale from the base view and also its style from the base view. Those, of course, can be turned off if I want to adjust them differently. Once more, I'll add back the hidden lines. By default, the isometric views do not show the hidden lines, though. I can double click any of these, and I can make them shaded views if I prefer. Base views can be created of assemblies in just the same way. I'll select an assembly from my drop-down list, and then once more I can adjust the view, then project as desired. I can also create base views of presentation files. This particular presentation file has a couple of snapshot views saved in it, so I can choose one of those and click OK to generate a view of my exploded assembly. I'll go ahead and blow this scale up to 1:1 so it'll fit better on this sheet of paper. I also have some additional options. You can see this part is a little difficult to see. I'm going to double click on this. Click on the Display Options tab, and I'm going to have it display tangent edges. Then click OK. Now I get a much better view of those components. So once again, you can use the base and projected view tools for parts, assemblies, and exploded presentation files. That concludes this look at base and projected views in Autodesk Inventor.